I had a conversation about this with a few callers last night, that it's one thing to sit here and say these athletes are contributing to this huge revenue that's being brought into college football. So I totally agree. Somebody brought it up to me last night, and they asked me when I first thought of it or first crossed my mind. And I said, well, when the whole Johnny Manziel thing came down, when he got suspended for the first half of the first game of the season after his Heisman season, that was back in 2013. I started posting videos saying that these guys need to benefit from this. I thought of it a whole different way at that time. But, you know, this has been talked about for even way before that.
I mean, Sam Keller, former Nebraska quarterback.
Okay. Yeah.
You know, Arizona State, Sam Keller, who transferred to Nebraska. He was a big guy that had a lawsuit out there going after that NIL.
So I think most of us agree that they deserve a share of the pie, but to work through all of that, it's a slippery slope that's going to have to be dealt with on so many different legal levels, revenue levels, trying to make sure that people aren't getting into this, that aren't supposed to be involved, that don't have the best intention for anybody, especially the athletes. There's a lot to consider here. I do not envy anybody who's going to be organizing this.
No, and you know, right now I probably know more than most people should know about kind of the way it's going to start working out. There's really coaches are not involved in any way in this. The student athlete has to go to compliance and tell them what they're doing, and basically that's it. And the company, the restaurant or the car dealership, anybody that's using you as an advertising, say for instance, like a podcast or radio show or something like that, that money does not go through a middle person. It goes right to the student athlete, and you know, the student athlete will have to sign a 1099. It's actually, the thing that's cool about it is Nebraska is ready for this starting July 1st. You know, several student athletes have already got the ball rolling and everything. So the question comes after that is how do you regulate it all? We're on a slippery slope with all of that, but it's happening. It's going to start happening right away. And you know what? We've heard for years and years that there's always that argument that do student athletes actually get paid or no? Does that scholarship equal pay? I mean, we know how much that scholarship is worth. But you know how much money the universities make off of these athletes with their NIL? It's millions, it's billions of dollars, you know. So it's finally going to start letting those athletes start to get to share in that. But like I said, it's going to be weird how we go about it in the future and try to regulate things and try to keep things on an equal playing field for every school. And I think then you add on with the Supreme Court ruling that we just had come down that the NCAA is probably on its way out, because any more lawsuits that come against the NCAA over any of this, they're going to lose. And it's just crazy. I mean, everything's changed, and it's, you know, I think college football now is, it benefits the fans the most, and it benefits the athletes. So it's great, if you ask me. I love all these changes that we're seeing. And plus, we got the 12-team playoff as well.
I agree with you. I don't like every little specific tidbit about it, but overall, 90-some percent positive, going in the right direction of what needs to happen in this day and age, and what needs to happen to benefit the athlete, because they lay a whole lot on the line. And I have always felt as though they do receive an income to a certain extent, because the college education is worth a whole lot, but they are contributing so much to where it was always unfair. I think anyone would agree. Most people agree that it was unfair that they couldn't go out there and earn extra income like anybody else on scholarship. The science major who has a full ride, but also can go out there and get a job. Well, they're working a job. They put in just ridiculous amounts of time.
And of course, too, I think the thing that helps out a lot with this recent Supreme Court ruling is that that's going to help out those student athletes that are not the high profile ones, that are not getting anything from the NIL. You know, basically they're being granted the increased benefits and some extra money, and you know, universities will work a way around for this to let all those athletes benefit from all of this. So it's a win-win, I think, for every student athlete out there, every potential student athlete out there. And you know what? It might give some kids more incentive to stay in college as well. So I like it.